Everybody, my name is Yassine, so I'm French, sorry my language and my accent. I'm a bit stressed here because, I never made a presentation in English before. And last RubyConf we was only like 10, maybe 15, but tonight we are 50 and I'm very scared. So I want to talk to you about the subject. It's more like, I mean, everybody here is kind of a Ruby developer. And in Ruby developer, there is Ruby, of course, but there is also developer. So the subject is more like for common developers. It's solving problems. That's what we do every day. And this problem is at the same time simple problem, hard to resolve, and we'll see a way to resolve it. Not complicated way, actually. A way for lazy people. So just let me explain you the problem. So I named this problem, I tried to make a problem looking cool, you know, like medieval and Game of Thrones and everybody want to kill this guy. And so I named it the King and the 99 Mercenary. So once upon a time, because it's a tale, once upon a time there is an ambitious king. And he wants to be an emperor or emperador. Okay. So the problem is he doesn't have enough money and enough troops. That meaning it's quite hard for him to rule all the world if he doesn't have enough. But he has a clever idea actually. Great idea. I think he's a genius. So the idea of this guy is to hire 99 mercenaries, the best one, you know, the beast. You know, the Amazon, the axe thrower, this kind of very big guy, Conan the Warrior. And to pay them with loot and resources from conquered city. That meaning he doesn't have yet the money. But he's thinking like this, I'm hiring him, we kill everybody, we loot everybody, everything, and we give to the mercenary. Problem solved. Not really, but... So, he has just one problem. Mercenary asks for gold. And the problem is, even if he loots all the city, he will never have enough gold for each mercenary. Because gold is very rare. So he has another good idea. He says, okay, you gladiator, I want you want 67 pieces of gold. So, but if I don't have enough gold, what do you accept as resource? And here the gladiator, of course, accepts slaves, mostly girl slaves, because you know gladiators are very focused on girls. Okay, and like this, he asked for the 99 mercenaries. So each mercenary saying, of course, yes for God, because everybody loves God. But not everybody accepts gold, for example. Not everybody accepts gold, not everybody accepts slaves. So he has this table, which is 99 lines with I accept this, I accept this, and I want this in total. The problem begins to come here. So let's loot. We are going to loot a lot of village. So kill people, everything, you know. We loot a lot. So much loot. Even some legendary stuff for the player here. So at the end of the loot we hold the empire. But we have an issue. The 99 mercenaries are quite angry. They did the work and they want to get paid. So it's time to dispatch the loot. And now, okay, the king takes his Excel file and holy mother of. And there is a lot of lines. Actually, on this here, there is like 35 lines. But the 99 lines is a lot, actually. So just imagine, he needs to dispatch his resources to the mercenaries. But the fact is, if it's dispatched completely randomly, at one moment you will have not enough slaves. And then the last mercenary will ask for slaves, and he doesn't ask for wood, so he cannot dispatch the wood to this guy. So we need to come back, we need to change, remove some slaves here, add some wood here, and do like this, okay? So end of our story, our king, which is an emperor, gets stabbed in the back, like Pisa, by one of the mercenaries. Because he doesn't have time to dispatch the money. They get too hungry. like reduce the study in the back. So now we are thinking, how can we solve this problem? This problem, and how can we solve it fast, you know? So we ask help for a very, very wisdom guy, which name is Darwin. Okay. I know it's like an anachronism, I mean, Darwin is, we are in the medieval time, but let's do it. Let's ask for Darwin helps me. So we will implement something which is called genetic algorithm and evolution. And you will see it's quite simple. That's why it's cool. So at first, just think about the problem. Let's try to think some things about the problem. So what's the problem? Is there only one solution? It's like like a maze, you can go out of the maze or something. No, I don't think so in this case. Is there many solutions possible? Yeah, probably. Is there at least one solution? We are not even sure. Maybe we didn't put enough to make happy all the mercenaries. And if not, then that's the key of the problem. If not, is there a better solution than others? And of course, is it? If we pay almost all mercenaries, we have few chances to get killed. So let's think like this. A solution is an organism. An organism is like growing and it's like bacteria or like you and us, like everybody. It's an organism, it's living. So it has performance, it performs inside an environment. That meaning elephants are very performant. Like giraffe, they are performant because they have a big neck. So they can eat on the top of the trees. So this is like something very specific but very performant for the environment of okay? So they compete with other solutions, like organisms. They get eaten by each other and something like that. And only the best survive. Okay, so let's think good solutions are organisms. So what is a good solution? That's the key. What is the fitness? What is the performance of a solution? So the key of our problem is the king should survive. That's the most important part. That meaning he should not get starved by mercenary. And if he doesn't want to get starved by mercenary, every mercenary should be happy enough to go betray the king. That's the important part. So this looks complicated, it's not so much. We ignore this. It's just like a math problem. So we just have something which is happiness and chance to betray. Chance to betray is like a factor of the happiness. And we have just this thing. If the mercenary has what they expect to, they will not betray the king. Okay? If they have like 80% of what they expect to, there is 2% chance they will betray the king. And if they have less than expected, more they will try to betray the king. Okay, so this is the key of the problem. So we have like percentage, like this one have a 2% chance to kill me, and we just multiply the percentage. So we make a product with each other, you know, basic, I don't know the word, sorry, in English. But yeah, it's quite easy, just multiplication. So what we will do is we will create a random solution, completely random. We will put everything. This guy wants wood, let's put some wood. I don't know how many, but let's put some wood. This guy wants slaves, let's put some slaves, and something like that. Okay? So then we compute the chance type. For each guy, we will check, okay, how much he's happy, what is his expectation, what he has, what is his happiness. So then we sort the random solution, and we keep the best. And then we take the best. That meaning we change just a few things. Oh, this guy has 12 wood? No, he has only 8 wood. That meaning someone has 4 wood somewhere. No, but we just change some things like this and we try if it's better or if it's not better. If it's better, we keep it. If it's not better, then we repeat, while through, or while 42. Repeat, like this. And we repeat millions of times. So it's like we don't work, it's just the luck or I don't know, destiny, the fate is working for us. That's what I love in this solution. It's not so hard. I mean, you just have to know the performance of the solution and then after you just be lazy, let's do the computer for you. So this is the same schematic, but sadly we don't see it very well. But it's exactly the same, and it's like an organigram. I think sometimes a picture is better than text. So we have random, we mutate, we select the best of them, we keep it, and we do it again. Okay. So this is not important. So that's easy. That's what I said. I really love it because for lazy people it's cool. You just have to set the performance and you let the program do it. After 30 seconds, you check, oh, my result is quite good. So, yes, and F for the intelligent design. That's just something, you know, some people in US mostly say they think evolution doesn't exist. And I can prove it exists because it exists even in computers. So. So we have just two issues with the implementation before we can implement it. The first is how to mutate easily. So that meaning, you see, if I remove forward to one of the guys, I should put forward to someone. But which one? How I can do this? Oh my god, this is a pain, you know. And we try to find a way to mutate easily. And the second problem we have with an implementation, if we want to implement this, is how to deal with local optimum. So I will just explain you after local optimum. It's something very easy also. So if you want to mutate easily, so one of the key we can do is to put completely random number in any wanted resource. So we ignore the resource they don't ask for. If the mercenaries don't ask for slave, we ignore slave completely. We don't put anything. We put zero. But otherwise, we put a random number. When we sum all the columns, and we divide all the number by the sum of the column, so we get a number between 0 and 1, which is like a percentage of the resource stack we will allow to the mercenary. And we multiply by the total resource. And 4, we fix the floating remnant that we will not see it. And so I have here an example. Sadly, it's a PDF. This example should be editable, so I can show you. But I will try to. And it's a bit small also. Sorry. But here you have just random number here between 1 and 1,000 or 10,000. Between 1 and 10,000, you put anything, we get the sum, we divide this by this, and we multiply by the total we have looped. And we have what everybody has. And after, we can have what we give to the guy, what was his expectation. So he was here, the gladiator was expecting 67, he will have 51, so we can say he's 77% happy, and he will, there is like 4% chance he will betray the king, and there is 96% chance he will not. So, like this, we just have to remove one, change one of the random number, and change the array, so it's like a mutation. Okay. So the advantage is mutation is easy. We just have to, here in Ruby, for example, if we want to mutate 8 times, we just have to take a random mercenary, take a random resource he asked for, and put a number, which is a random number. So it's very easy, just one access. And the second part is local optimum. What is a local optimum is, imagine here, it looks like the best result. Best performance, but it's not actually, there is another performance. And the problem when you mutate things like only 8 mutations per single, you will get some trouble. That meaning you will mutate here, but because it's not better, you will remove it. So we keep it on the top of this mountain. We will never go on the top of the bigger mountain. So that's a big issue, because it will look like, oh, we have the best result, but it's not actually. So we have one answer, it's called the island, like the Philippines island. So it's quite easy. We have algorithm. We have exactly the same, but with different islands. That meaning on each island there is different organisms. They compete to each other, but they don't compete with the organism from other islands. And then at a certain moment, after 5,000 iterations or something, we collide the islands, and then they compete each other. And then the weaker island, for example this one, gets loose, so start random, new again. start from the start again. And we do it, okay? You need to imagine we do it a million of times. You know, a computer can do it well and very fast. So we make it like 5 million times per second. So that's why this solution is cool. So at the final, we have around 300 lines of code, so this is not very complicated to make. But when I say 300 lines of code, it's in C, not in Ruby, because I have implemented this method in C for performance, actually. But 300 lines of code in C, it's peanuts. Okay, in Ruby it's cool, because Ruby you can do a lot of things with only one line, so 300 lines of code in Ruby it's almost a small application. But in C it's nothing. And we have millions of new solutions per second, and we have a life-saving result in 30 seconds, and the king can be alive. Hooray to the king! And so I have to Ruby. For favor, do this in C if possible. Ruby is way too slow for this. We are trying with Ruby. Ruby is not done for AV computation. I really love Ruby. Don't tell me I'm a handful of Ruby. I love Ruby. I'm a big Ruby fan. But this kind of thing should be done for the policy. Because it's quite simple. If you use your algorithm 2 seconds in C, in Ruby it will take 20 seconds. So imagine the difference of performance. And sometimes it can be a bit long. When I say long, it's like 10 seconds of computation. Okay. So this is. So there is this sentence Albert Einstein say, and actually the sentence is wrong. He said, God doesn't play dice, talking about the quantum theory. But actually, God, at what we know, play dice in the quantum theory. But actually, both developers should probably sometimes play dice. Because that's a good way to resolve a problem which is looking very complex. If you imagine it with graph and node and everything, and a lot of loop, and then, come on. Sometimes it's good to be stupid and to let the nature make the work for us. So, and I think it's all. So just the last word. As you can see, it's about mercenary king and everything. That's a real life problem. It's just about tax processing in France. So I would be able to make it about tax processing in France, but I think it was more fun with a king and mercenaries and more easy to understand. But the problem is, in France, you replace the mercenary by school and the king by companies. Companies need to give money to the school, but they need to give a certain amount in a certain condition and everything. And for example, this problem we had this company Bridgestone, you know, they make the tires. Big company in France, they are big companies. They have like 5 million euros to spend to 99 schools. So this number 99 is not a number I just think like this. It's something happening really. So they need to give money to 99 schools. Before, an accountant take 1 month to make it. Meaning 1 month on the Excel, changing the things to make it working. Seriously, a guy just on one worksheet, taking 1 month of work just to type and changing the coefficient, the money for each school about some categories like this. We solve this problem, and in 30 seconds, we get a result like 1 month of work for human. When we presented it to the accountant, she cried and she said she will lose her job. And I didn't expect that. I was like very happy about what I did, and then she gets mad and everything, so I was like, oh, okay. Okay, that's all. Thank you.